Hey guys, guess what? I've bought a car. You know, when I first started putting this video together and I started going through all the clips, it just didn't feel right. I was too preoccupied with the research and with the roadworthy and the paperwork and everything. It looked like a lot of hard work, which it was, but I think this video needs to start with joy. I am now the owner of a Subaru SVX, and not only any Subaru SVX, the actual Subaru SVX that was on the cover of the January 1994 issue of Car Magazine and the road test car of that issue. Now, if you know my history, as you know, with Car Magazine, I'm sure you'll understand that that's quite special to me. This car is by no means perfect. It's going to take some time to get her to where she needs to be, but just let me put it this way. This car in January 1994 cost 325,000 rand. As much as a Mercedes-Benz S-Class in 1994. You know how much I paid for this? 55,000. Now, I think the price alone should tell you that there's some work that needs to be done to this car. But I can say this, mechanically, this thing feels solid. Cosmetically, it needs a lot of work. But you'll see in this video that it wasn't quite as bad as I had initially thought, I think. We will see next week. But in this video, I will take you through my day, basically, of buying a very rare, in South Africa anyway, I believe only 18 came into the country, Subaru SVX. Putting it through roadworthy, getting the paperwork done, and then discovering that I'm too embarrassed to bring it to the office because it's so filthy. Taking it to the nearest valet center and finding a place where I think I won't only have this car brought back, you know, to what it really should look like, but also a place that might in the long run save me a lot of money, because I might avoid having to spray paint the car. So tonight, my first drive in my Subaru SVX, I'm gonna go to Atlantic Seaport side, watch the sunset, hopefully take a photo or two, and just enjoy the moment, because they're rare. A week ago, you know, a Subaru SVX was sort of in my periphery, but I wouldn't have put money on owning one a week later. So this is my happy face. I'm a bit like Kimi Raikkonen. My happy face is my sad face, is my angry face, it's all the same. Sorry, it's just how it is. Guys, if you like my videos, there's a lot more coming. Please do subscribe. I have a lot of books to give away. And if you're from South Africa, go to my About page or my About section, find my email address, pop me a message, subscribe. I'll get a signed book to you, if you want it signed. Some of you might not want to. Morning guys, and welcome to Cape Town morning traffic on a Friday. It's not the greatest way to start a day, but it is going to be a great day because I have decided to buy a new car. Well, I've decided to buy an old car. A new old car, I guess. If you remember that Subaru SVX in the previous video, I'm going to buy it, and I'll tell you why in a bit.
Small change from normal procedures is that I'm still going to drive a new car to where I'm buying the old car, like in the previous videos. But I'm going to strip out the bit about the new car and make its own video out of that. And so this video will be shorter and only focused on the SVX, whereas there's a whole separate video on the new car. And the new car I'm driving today is going to be of interest to a lot of you who are shopping for a compact crossover, which is almost everyone. It is the Chery Tiggo Pro, Tiggo 4 Pro SE. I think I've got that right. So if you want to know more about that car, look out for a video on that vehicle on my channel somewhere in a new playlist about new cars. This video specifically is going to be all about why I'm buying a Subaru SVX and me hoping and praying as we put it through roadworthy, and God willing, getting all the paperwork done and having it in my garage tonight. So here we are, the big moment at Somerset-West test station to have the SVX roadworthied again. It actually had a roadworthy done not so long ago, but that's lapsed, so it's time to have it done again. Looks like a very good facility. First in line today, no troubles. Just noticing some fog in the lights that I'm gonna have to get out. But a good detailing service is definitely on the cards. You know, passing roadworthy at first try would really save me a lot of time today, so I'm really holding thumbs here. But this car has been in the care of one of only two Subaru Master technicians in the Western Cape, so it should go through. I really hope so. Yeah, it sounds painful. Feel sorry for the car. Here we go, fully roadworthied. Here's the price. Now off to licensing. Okay guys, so we're back in the Chery Tiggo, as you can see. And sure, sometimes you do have to appreciate modern cars with air conditioning and things like that that work. So the Subaru has been roadworthied. It passed with flying colors. As I drove it around this morning, I did discover a few things that we need to add to the list to fix, including some panel in the passenger footwell that fell off. The aircon definitely needs a regas. Yeah, and I think there's probably a few of the trim pieces that's just better, you know, being replaced than being try to rescue them. So what's happening now is I've already been to the traffic department. I've gone to fetch the two necessary documents, the registration document and the change of ownership document, which I'm now going to sit in a coffee shop and complete as best I can, and trying to get all my documents together. I'm gonna stick around in Somerset West. Maybe we can get all this done today. If not, the full registration process here in Somerset West, I would obviously need to register it in Cape Town. But there's still a chance that I can drive this car back to Cape Town today.
Well, and almost unbelievably, Just 2 hours later, I was driving the SVX away from where it had been parked for the last few months. Thanks to some great assistance from the previous owner, as well as the car's minder for the past few months and my own team members for fetching the cherry, I was able to collect the keys for the SVX on this very same day. As I drove it away though, and I realized that I had about 3 hours before close of business, I just thought, you know, it's a bit of a drive to Cape Town. I really want to show the car to my colleagues, and I really didn't want to show it in its current state. So I googled the nearest car wash and took it for a wash immediately.
Yeah, so literally 5 minutes after picking up the Subaru, just decided I couldn't drive it in, you know, in that kind of condition. So drove it to the Spa Car Wash and Detailing Center in Somerset-West. And they're going to do the best they can do within the 2 hours that we have for the rest of the day. And I'm sure she'll be looking a lot better, even with sort of one of their minor treatments. So, yeah, very excited to finally have my hands on the keys, and the improvements start now. You can see there's lots of work in the difficult spot that still lies ahead. Not for today though.
So as you guys can see here, the roof is really faded. Standing in the sun the last few months has definitely taken its toll, so that's something I really want to fix. And then also the leather is really dry, and the dashboard up front specifically is really faded. So I hope these guys can do something about these things.
Give a demonstration here of how we're going to revive the black trim on the car, because that was a very faded door handle. That's amazing.
Private, we use solution black.
Solution black, eh? Not sure if you can see properly on this shot, but that part of it has been treated very quickly and this part hasn't. I mean, the difference is just phenomenal. Apologies for the noise. Car detailing and paint correction in progress. Yeah, it's Spa Car Wash and Detailing in Somerset-West. They're giving me a little taster of what they can do on one of the black trim pieces of the car, which is really faded. And then based on that, I'll decide whether I bring the car back for the full treatment next week, which will take a few days. But today we've only got 2 hours, and the work that they've already done is proving to be quite phenomenal. So yeah, I think, can you believe it, eh? Within 300 meters of the house where I fetched the car today, I find this place. That's just incredible. Yep, we're coming back here, that's for sure. Guys, some days just turn out better than what you expect, eh? So this morning when I took the SVX for its first drive to the roadworthy center, I must say the dirty windows and the sort of months of standing outside and the dull paintwork really got to me a bit. And so today when I picked it up, I decided I just need to give it like a quick wash, at least in a vacuum, before I would dare show my colleagues. And I googled the nearest car wash to where I picked it up and found this place, Spa Car Wash and Valet Center, yeah, in Somerset-West, just across the road. And what they've done in a very short space of time has been incredible. And they also demoed something to me which has taken one of my biggest fears away, and that is that I would have to repaint the car. So I'll bring the car back here next week and we are going to do a paint restoration correction on the car and some other treatments, and she'll be looking pretty much as good as new, which is incredible. But even just after this mini valet today, what a difference. 400 bucks, sure, some of the best 400 bucks I've spent in a long time.
Well guys, I'm the owner of this Subaru SVX. It still hasn't sunk in, to be honest. You know, going through the whole process of test driving and the research and roadworthy, it all felt kind of like, I don't know, like work almost. But now that I'm in the car, I'm on the highway, I'm on the way home to the office to go toast it with the team. Yeah, what a feeling. And you know, it was so good to have it cleaned. I can actually see out the windows. Makes a massive difference. Almost had a few accidents this morning because the windows were just so dirty. So as I said at the car spa, that I'm going to take it back there to have it fully done. So I'll be without it for a few days next week, but this weekend I intend to drive it. I've got a Superboss thing though tomorrow, so can't do tomorrow. But Sunday I will drive this, give it a bit of a spin. And then I think the next thing is to start making the list of the things that need fixing, like the aircon, like putting the original radio back, like figuring out how to adjust the steering wheel and to have it stay in a higher position. That still eludes me. Yeah, I think the entire ventilation system probably needs some work, because as far as I know, there's supposed to be some digital displays here, which there aren't. But yeah, I'm here on the highway on the N2. She runs beautifully, smoothly, track straight. The ride's good. There's no weird noises. The temperature gauge is staying steady. It's a pleasure, except old cars, eh? They can throw you curveballs. My window of vision to the road is like this much because of this. But strip of Velcro this weekend might sort that out temporarily. There could be much more serious issues, to be honest, than that. Oh, feels good, man. I just can't take the sun visor anymore, so I don't have Velcro. But I do have double-sided tape, so for now, this is going to be the solution, and hopefully it doesn't leave any kind of mark on the roof lining. But yeah, I just can't see anything. Gosh, that doesn't seem too effective. No, that doesn't work. So I've just put 500 bucks of fuel in the SVX. So far the needle's only gone up to around halfway, which is not what I'd hoped for. So I think we have a car with a bit of a drinking problem here. To be honest, I kind of expected that. It is a 3.3 liter flat six after all. Hopefully it's just a slow rise in the needle. Good news, asked them to check the oil and the water, and all fine. They even complimented me on the car. So I've got all four windows, well, I mean, if you can call them windows because they're so small, open at the moment. So
firstly, I hope you can hear me, but secondly, I also hope you can hear a little bit of the car going downhill now, so there's not much to listen to, but when I do. When I go over hard bumps, the ashtray pops open. It's another thing for the list. Ooh, that sounds a bit fruity, doesn't it? So as I'm cruising the strip here on a Sunday in Cape Town, obviously top of mind is making this list of things that need attending to, and I'm very pleased to say that mechanically it doesn't feel like there's a lot that's wrong with this car. Gearbox feels fine. I mean, it's slow as hell, but yeah, it's a little bit of a shudder, but too bad. I do know that the gearboxes are problematic. Luckily now I know a very good Subaru mechanic. All four windows, by the way, if you can call them windows, are now open, so hopefully you don't hear just wind noise, but also occasionally a little bit of engine noise. And yeah, steering feels good, a little bit off center, the brakes feel fine, very slight shudder on the brakes, the odd squeak, but the car's also not driven for a while. So I think most of the work will be cosmetic, so if the guys in Somerset-West are as good as they claim to be next week and they sort out a lot of the cosmetic issues in a non-invasive way, then you know, I'm on a winning wicket here. I guess we'll only know in about a week or so, but at this point as it stands, I think the most pressing matters post cosmetic treatment will be the climate control system, which I think is, yeah, I think there are big problems there, and then the replacing the old audio system, I mean the new audio system with the old audio system. And that really, I think in terms of things working or not working, is what I'm faced with in the next couple of months. I do think I'm going to replace most of the fake wood trim in this car. I'm going to try and get new wooden pieces for that. And then there are, I think maybe the seats need reupholstering. I need somebody to help me with the roof lining. The roof lining is beautiful, but it is sagging a little in places, so I need to do that. So it's not a heck of a lot of work, to be honest. So I think, you know, for 55,000 Rand, I mean, it's not throwaway money, but got a really unique rare car that is in very decent working condition, and with maybe some little bit of extra spend can look really amazing. So as I drive right here and there's only fake wood to touch, I can say that I think yeah, I've got a winner here. So keep an eye out for updates as we go along. It's always a journey with these old cars.